Hello, everyone. This is Rob Torres with NACA. Welcome to NACA Real Estate Training. Today, we're going to give you instructions on how to register to NACA as a real estate agent. This will give you access to an agent portal where you can refer your clients to the NACA program, right? And any clients you refer to NACA, NACA will refer that client back to you once they have become NACA qualified and they're ready to begin their housing search, right? So to register as a real estate agent to the NACA program, you will first need to go to our website, right? Under vendors in the menu, you scroll down to real estate agent and it will land you to the login page. Right. And it's really simple. It's not difficult. If this is your first time registering as a real estate agent, you'll go ahead and select not registered. You give us your contact information, the company that you're working for, the email address, and you create a password and you press submit. It's that simple. It's not that difficult. Right. If you're going to log in again, right, if you're already registered, then you'll go to already registered. Right. And you'll use the email address that you have used to register to the NACA program. That will be your username. Right. And you'll go ahead and you'll input the password that you created when you registered. Right. In the event if you forget that password, then all you have to do is click reset my password. The system will automatically create a temporary password and it will email it to the email address that you use when you first originally registered to the program, right? And you just go ahead and press login, right? So this will give you access. This is the agent portal, right? If you look up the upper right-hand corner, you'll see upload documents. This is where you're gonna upload your purchase and sales agreements, any amendments. And if you're currently working with a NACA member, this is where you're gonna go ahead and upload the buyer representations agreements, right? New client submission. This is strictly for non-NACA members, meaning that they have not been to a home buyer workshop and you're referring that client to the NACA program, right? Once you have uploaded the buyer representations agreements, then that particular person will get added to your referral client list, right? And this will help you keep track of your clients so you'll know where they are. And if you recall, any members that you refer to the NACA program, NACA will refer that member back to you once they have become NACA qualified and they're ready to begin their housing search. Now, change profile. This is in the event if you need to change your contact information, meaning that maybe you work for a different company now, you have a different email address that you would like to use, or you want to change your password. All right, so this is where you'll go ahead and change your realtor information. Now, to refer a new client, again, these are people that have not been to a workshop, right? This is a person who's brand new to NACA, and you're referring them to the NACA program. So you want to refer your client under new client submission. This is where it is. Right. So you type in the information. Now, what we're going to need is the last four digits of the social security number. Right. So we use that as the identifier. That's how we know that you are the real estate agent that referred the person to the program. Now, here where it says seller pays all costs. Well, that means that you're not charging, right, the client to come through this NACA program. Right. All fees are prohibited. It's one of the reasons why we want you to upload that buyer representations agreement, because we want to see that you're not charging people to come through this program. Unfortunately, there was a few bad apples out there that ruined it for everyone, and all fees are prohibited. You're not allowed to charge anyone to come through this NACA program. So this section should always be yes. Seller pays for all costs, right? Now, you go ahead and you type in the information and you upload your agreement, right? Now, the one thing that I do want to talk about a little bit, when you upload your agreements, right, it's got to be a PDF file, right? And the file size has to be 15 MBs and below, right? 15 MBs and below. If you're working with a file that's too large, then the system will not upload it, right? Now, there's a couple of ways that you could troubleshoot that, right? One, you could always go to your printer scanner settings under printer preferences, right? And what you can do is you can minimize the resolution. As you can see, it's at its max at 600 DPI. So what you could do is go ahead and reduce it to the lowest. In this case scenario, is 300 DPI, right? And once you scan it in, it will allow you to reduce the file size, and it will allow you to upload that agreement. Now, if you're using a color printer scanner, then you could also change the color option to black and white. This will also reduce the file to less than 15 MBs, and it will allow you to go ahead and upload that agreement to the portal. And then you'll go ahead and press submit. Once you have submitted, as you can see, the person is added to your client list, right? And this will give you the ability to check the status to see where they are. And again, anyone that you refer to NACA, NACA will refer that person back to you once that they have become NACA qualified. Right? Now, in the event if you're working with a NACA member, maybe you did such a fantastic job and someone reached out to you. This is a person that been through the process. They got qualified. They already have their NACA ID number. Here, you'll go ahead and type in their NACA ID number. First three letters of the person's last name. And then you press submit. Again, you go ahead and choose your file. The agreement date, the expiration date, yes, and then you press submit, right? It's that simple. It's not that difficult to do. And let's go ahead and press submit. Once you submit, you should see your submission was saved successfully. That's how you know the system took the buyer representations agreements. As you can see, it doesn't get added to your client list because, you know, this is a person that you did not refer to the program, right? The refer client list is only for buyers that you refer to the NACA program. And as you can see, this is not a difficult system to work with, right? It's pretty much simple. We really appreciate your participation with the NACA program. You know, I'm a firm believer that preparing for someone for home ownership is more than bank statements and pay stubs. It's really partnering up with seasoned-minded real estate agents that have a mission attitude, that's willing to roll up their sleeves and help out a community that really needs the help. And I'd like to thank you so much for your participation. If you have any questions, you know, please don't hesitate to reach out to Real Estate Department. We're here to help you and to give you all the tools that you guys are gonna need in order to be successful and to ensure that you represent the clients that are coming through the NACA program well. Again, thank you so much, and you guys make it a blessed day. Bye-bye.